course not work. Put the card on the side of the deck as shown, and practice using your thumb to slide it flush onto the deck. This is the secret to the trick. As your hand comes over, the box instantly disappears. The middle card changes from black to red. The magician takes a deck of cards and shuffles them. He then takes the top card and tells the spectator he will rub it into the table and make it disappear. He rubs the card, but it doesn't disappear. He tries again, and the card disappears completely. This is a very simple trick. Take a card and try and rub it into the table. This will of course not work. Put the card on the side of the deck as shown, and practice using your thumb to
see.
And practice using your thumb to slide it flush onto the deck. This is the side using your thumb. This will of course not work. Put the card on the side of the deck as shown, and practice using your thumb to using your thumb to slide it flush onto the deck. This is the secret to the trick. As your hand comes over, it looks like you're taking the card, when in reality, you're just sliding it back onto the top of the deck. Turn your wrist over too, and this will make the vanish look even more deceiving. The magician takes a deck of cards, and they vanish instantly. This trick requires you to lap the box. As you open your hand, use the thumb to fire the box back down into your lap. This will create the convincing illusion that you've just vanished the box. This trick does require a table to perform. When in reality, you're just sliding it back onto the top of the deck. Turn your wrist over too, and this will make the vanish look even more deceiving. The magician takes a deck of cards, and they vanish instantly. This trick requires you to lap the box. As you open your hand, use the thumb to fire the box back down into your lap. This will create the convincing illusion that you've just vanished the box. This trick does require a table to perform. This trick requires you to lap the box. As you open your hand, use the thumb to fire the box back down into your lap. This will create the convincing illusion that you've just vanished the box. This trick does require a table to perform. The magician visually changes the top card. This is called the Erdenes change. Use your palm to push forward the top card as shown. This will reveal the card below. Then use the base of your hand to pull back the bottom card. This will cause it to slide out the pack. Now push it over the top card using your palm. This will create the illusion that the top card has changed. You need to practice this move for a little while before you can perform it. If you are interested in learning incredible card magic, then use the base of your hand. The magician visually changes the top card. This is called the Erdenes change. Use your palm to push forward the top card as shown. This will reveal the card below. Then use the base of your hand to pull back the bottom card. This will cause it to slide out the pack. Now push it over the top card using your palm. This will create the illusion that the top card has changed. You need to practice this move for a little while before you can perform it. If you are interested in learning incredible card magic, including flourishes, sleights, tricks, and more, and tricks that are just too good to reveal on YouTube, then check out my magic course in the first link in the description below. The course contains some of the best tricks ever created. The magician produces a card from nowhere. This trick requires you to get into the JW grip. Place the short edge of the card against your middle finger, and then use the rest of your fingers to cover it as shown. You can now reach through and grab this card, and it will look as if it's been produced from nowhere. The magician takes a deck, turns over the top card, and shakes it, and it changes. This is a very powerful and easy trick to do. Turn over the top card. The magician takes a deck, turns over the top card, and shakes it, and it changes. This is a very powerful and easy trick to do.
Oh my god. Is it?
Turn over the top card and reveal its value. The magician produces a card from nowhere. This trick requires you to get into the JW grip. Place the short edge of the card against your middle finger, and then use the rest of your fingers to cover it as shown. You can now reach through and grab this card, and it will look as if it's been produced from nowhere. The magician takes a deck, turns over the top card, and shakes it, and it changes. This is a very powerful and easy trick to do. Turn over the top card and reveal its value. You now need to get a break under the top two cards. You can do this in any way you please. I use a pinky count, but you can simply grab the top two cards if you like. Place the corners of these cards between your thumb and middle finger, and then using your first finger, rotate the card. To perform the change, simply do this rotation while shaking the card. I use a pinky count, but you can simply grab the top two cards if you like. Place the corners of these cards between your thumb and middle finger, and then using your first finger, rotate the card. to perform the change, simply do this rotation while shaking the card. But you can simply grab the top two cards if you like. Place the corners of these cards between your thumb and middle finger, and then using your first finger, rotate the card. To perform the change, simply do this rotation while shaking the card. The card disappears and reappears. This trick requires a single card, holding from nowhere. The magician takes a deck, turns over the top card, and shakes it, and it changes. This is a very powerful and easy trick to do. Turn over the top card and reveal its value. You now need to get a break under the top two cards. You can do this in any way you please. I use a pinky count, but you can simply grab the top two cards if you like. Place the corners of these cards between your thumb and middle finger, and then using your first finger, rotate the card. To perform the change, simply do this rotation while shaking the card. The card disappears and reappears. This trick requires a single card. Hold the top edge of the card between your first finger, middle finger, and thumb. Extend your middle finger slightly and pull back on the card. This move is called the flip card. The card disappears and reappears. This trick requires a single card. Hold the top edge of the card between your first finger, middle finger, and thumb. Extend your middle finger slightly and pull back on the card. This move is called the flip stick. Practice the flip stick until it's fast. Now perform the flip stick under the cover of your other hand, and the card will appear to vanish. The magician takes a card and floats it in between his hands. He then catches the card again. This trick requires some invisible thread. I'll leave a link in the description where you can buy this. It's very cheap to get. It's hard to see on camera, but there's a thin thread that stretches around my hand. Place the thread around your hand and thumb, then using your other hand, loop it around your first finger. This creates a base where you can place a card on top of it. The card will look as if it's floating. This is incredibly visual and mystical magic. The magician has a deck of cards. He turns over the top card, and it suddenly changes colour. This is quite an easy trick. Turn over the top card, and then you need to get a break under the top card and the card below it. I use a pinky count, but do this in any way you like. You can just grab the top two cards if you like. Hold the cards between your thumb and middle finger. Then using the hand holding the deck, pull down on the corners of the card. This creates tension, and when you release enough pressure, the card will flip over. Keep practicing this and you can flip the cards if you like. Hold the cards between your thumb and middle finger. Then using the hand holding the deck, pull down on the corners of the card. This creates tension, and when you release enough pressure, the card will flip over. Keep practicing this and you can flip the card all the way over, and the card will appear to change. The coin changes into a card. This trick is incredibly visual. This trick requires a coin and a card. Practice dropping the coin onto your hand as shown. This is quite simple to do. This creates the illusion that the coin is gone. Hold the card in JW grip that I taught you earlier and practice producing it by flicking your wrist forwards. Now just perform both moves at the same time. This trick is effective because two visual bits of magic happen at the same time. The card disappears into thin air. This trick requires you to place a magnet on the back of the card. You can use blue tack or glue. You also need a magnet attached to an elastic thread. I'll leave a link in the description where you can get one of these, or you can make it yourself. The magnet will stick to the card. Clip the elastic to your shirt by using a safety pin. When you let go of the card, it will fire back and appear to vanish visually. The card visually changes colour. Hold two cards between your first finger, middle finger, and thumb. Using your first finger, pull the first card towards you in a snapping motion. Keep practicing this move until it's almost instantaneous. Make sure that the face of the card is angled towards the spectator's eyeline so they cannot see the card hidden behind it. This is called the snap change. The magician has three cards. He tells the spectator to focus on the middle card, which is black. He snaps his fingers, and the card suddenly changes colour. This trick requires four cards. I use two jokers, a black card and a red card. Practice the snap change that I just taught you in the previous trick. Now simply do this with one joker behind and in front of the two cards. Your middle finger should be in between the front card and the middle card to perform the snap change. If you've learnt the snap change, then this trick is very easy to do. It just looks even more impossible because the cards seem to be trapped by two other cards. Please subscribe to this channel if you haven't already, and follow my Instagram. I'll leave a link in the description where you can find it.
Guys, Spidey here, and this week we're gonna learn my favorite visual card trick.
The card levitates between
the magician plucks a card out of thin air. He folds up the money and changes it into a card. The card visually vanishes. This fools magicians. The magician takes the Jack of Spades and transforms it. The Nine of Hearts changes to the Ace of Spades. Thank you to Current for making this video possible. I'm also going to teach you the same trick that James Woo did in Ant-Man, where he plucks a card out of thin air. Hey, how's it going, everybody? Oscar Owen here, and it's been a while since I've done a video just teaching some regular card tricks. So in this video, I've put together some of my favorite visual and easy to do card tricks that most of them you can learn in about 30 seconds. So without any further ado, let's go to the card table and start learning. I'm going to teach you how to pluck cards from thin air. You can learn this in less than 30 seconds. Let me teach you how. Take any card and place it onto your palm like this. Then bend your fingers in, creating tension in the card. Bring your thumb under the bent card and use it to grab the card with your first finger. This creates a popping card production. Keep practicing this move until it's natural. Then simply do this in front of your spectator's eye line, and it creates the convincing illusion that the card has been plucked from thin air. The easiest card trick in the world. The magician takes the Jack of Hearts and then suddenly changes it into the Two of Clubs. Let me teach you how to do this. Use your thumb to riffle up the back of the deck until you've got two cards remaining. Then practice turning over these two cards as one, following how I do it on the screen. Then show the spectator the Jack of Hearts, and then turn it back round. Now pick up the top card and reveal that it's magically changed. The magician vanishes the debit card and then makes it reappear. Hold the card between your middle finger, first finger and thumb like this. Then extend your middle finger and pull back on the card, and you'll notice that it goes into your palm. Keep practicing this move, so pull the card back and then use your thumb to push the card back out. Just reverse what you've just done. Keep practicing this until it's smooth, and once you can do it, you're ready to move on. Now simply do this move under the cover of your other hand. So your other hand comes over, you pull the card into your palm, and then you twist this hand around to show the card is gone. You twist the hand back around, push the card back out, and it creates the very convincing illusion that you've just taken a card and then made it reappear. Speaking of magic with debit cards, let's take a look at a different kind of magic with this week's video sponsor, Current. So Current is a mobile app and debit card that makes spending and saving money so much easier. They have a really clean and easy to use app that lets you send and request money from friends with no hidden fees. They also give you a Visa debit card like this one, which you can not only perform some really cool magic tricks with, but it just takes the confusion out of banking. For example, the app gives you a really clean breakdown of your spending insights and gives you instant notifications when you make a transaction. I really genuinely recommend it to anyone who's looking for a simple and easy way to take control of their money. So check them out in the first link in the description. They're a really great company with so many other bonuses, such as cash.
Two cards and place one behind the other. Then grab both cards with your first finger, middle finger and thumb in this position here. You want to extend your middle finger and pull back on the first card so that it slides behind the other card, almost in a snapping motion. So just practice this over and over again. Start off slow, and the more you practice it, the faster you'll be able to get it.
The magician waves the fan over the card packet, and the packet disappears.
For this trick, you need to know how to do a smear fan. So I'm not going to teach this in this video, so go and find another tutorial on YouTube and then come back to this tutorial here. So to begin, split the deck into two packets and then display one half to the spectator, and then with the other half, do a smear fan. You then want to just brush up and down the fan like this. And then on the third brush, all that's happening is you're chucking the cards and catching them with your finger behind the deck like that, so they're hidden behind the fan. So it looks like this. You go 1, 2, 3, and you catch the cards like that. As ball full speed from the front, you're showing the cards like this, then you're brushing once, twice, and then you're just catching them behind like that. You can then square everything up and continue. This, in my opinion, is more of a flourish than an actual trick, but I still think it looks really beautiful, so I wanted to teach it in this video.
The magician folds up the money and visually changes it into a playing card. This trick requires a banknote and two playing cards. Place the money on the back of one card and then fold the bill so it matches the length of the card as shown. Now fold the bill in half the opposite way. Now stick one side of the bill to the card using double-sided tape. Fold the bill down and then the other card will be stuck onto it like this. Add double-sided tape to the bill and the card and then press them together. You've now created the gimmick. To perform the trick, fold the bill inwards, then place your finger in the flap. As you shake, close the flap using your fingers. You can now display the card cleanly. Let's learn the same production that AMC Wu does in the Ant-Man film. The magician waves his hands and then produces a card. Take your hand and turn it into a Spider-Man grip like this. Then take a playing card and place it onto your fingers in this position here. And then move your middle two fingers out so you can clip the playing card like this. This is called a back palm. What you now need to do is practice moving your hand forward to produce the card, then using your thumb to grab the card, and then moving your hands out to display it like this. So let me just do that again. You've got the card in back palm. You move all your fingers forward to produce the card, grab it with your thumb, and then move all your fingers back to produce it. Practice this over and over, and you'll get it to this point here. The final thing you need to do is just wave your hand up and down to hide these little two bits of white that are sticking through your fingers. So wave your hand like this, then produce the card. I'm going to teach you how to throw a card and visually change it. Here's what it looks like in a performance. The spectator chooses any card, in this case the Ace of Spades. This is placed into the deck. The magician then flips the deck over and says your card is on top. However, the Nine of Hearts is on top. The magician looks confused and places the Nine of Hearts to the side. He then throws it through the deck and changes it into the spectator's selection. This is hypervisual and the ace can be inspected. Take around 1.5 inches of double-sided tape and stick it to the back of the top playing card. Once you've done that, you're ready to begin, so let the spectator choose any card, making sure they don't pick the top card. Then what you need to do is let them see their card, and it's okay if you see it as well, and turn the deck over at the same time. Once you've done this, take back their card and place it under all the cards, bar the bottom one, which has got the double-sided tape on it. So as you can see here, their selection goes into the deck, and now if we turn the deck over, there's the one with the double-sided tape on it, and the spectator selection is directly underneath. Now what you need to do is snap your fingers, turn over the top card, and just say something like, "This obviously wasn't your card, was it?" They will say no, and as you do this, press down on the Nine of Hearts, and it will stick to the spectator's selection. From here, you can just toss this to the side, and then place the deck down onto the table. Use some double-sided tape, and stick it to the back of the top playing card. Once you've done that, you're ready to begin, so let the spectator choose any card, making sure they don't pick the top card. Then what you need to do is let them see their card, and it's okay if you see it as well, and turn the deck over at the same time. Once you've done this, take back their card and place it under all the cards, bar the bottom one, which has got the double-sided tape on it. So as you can see here, their selection goes into the deck, and now if we turn the deck over, there's the one with the double-sided tape on it, and the spectator selection is directly underneath. Now what you need to do is snap your fingers, turn over the top card, and just say something like, "This obviously wasn't your card, was it?" They will say no, and as you do this, press down on the Nine of Hearts, and it will stick to the spectator's selection. From here, you can just toss this to the side, and then place the deck down onto the table. This is the bit you're going to need practice, but this literally takes 30 seconds to learn. You're going to need to practice throwing this card and flipping it over to reveal their selection. So to do this, just rotate your wrist as you throw the card and it looks as if the Nine of Hearts is changing to their selection. Just do this under the deck and it creates a very visual colour change. From here, you can then just peel off their selection from the tape and hand it out to be inspected. The card visually vanishes. This is an amazing effect that I learned from another YouTube channel, and I just love it because I think it's so visual and easy to do. So I've left a link down in the description to the original performer of this trick, where you can also learn how to do this effect because they teach it as well. So all you need to do is take any playing card
and just fold it in half like this, and then fold this bit down in half like that. So you've created this zigzag fold in the card. What I've actually done is scored this as well to get really clean folds. So there's a fold here and there's a fold here. Take the bottom fold and cover it with your hand, and then take these two fingers and pinch the bottom corner of the card. All that's going to happen is you are going to use your thumb to pull the card down like that, whilst your thumb and first finger move away. From the front view, it looks like this. You move your thumb and pull the card down whilst you move your hand away, and it looks as if the card is vanishing. The card will naturally fall into a finger palm, and you can just do this to create the illusion that the card's gone.
The magician flicks the deck and finds the spectator's card. The cap goes through the bottle. The red card visually melts through the blue card. The four splits into two twos. The red deck changes into a blue deck. I'm also going to reveal the cleanest vanish ever created. The magician places the coin in his hand and tosses it into his other hand. And then the coin is gone. Hey, how's it going, everybody? Oscar Owen here, and in this video, I'm going to be teaching you some incredible magic tricks that anybody can do. I've made sure that these tricks are both visual and easy to perform so that you can start performing them right away. I'm going to show you the fastest way to locate a spectator's chosen card. This is the kind of move that looks like you've taken 10 years to learn it, when in reality it only takes 10 seconds to learn. The spectator chooses a card, in this case the Queen of Clubs. This is then cut into the deck fairly. The magician says he will find the spectator's card in a strange way. He takes his finger and flicks the deck. The next card down is the spectator's Queen of Clubs.
This is a really easy effect you can do with any deck of cards. The first thing you need to do beforehand is prep one card and crimp it. To do this, place both thumbs in the middle of the card and move outwards, and this will bend the card in a diagonal position. Then do it down the other diagonal, and you've created your crimped card. This puts a slight bend in the card, which will allow us to flick it later on. Now let the spectator choose any card that they like. In this case, the spectator has chosen the Seven of Diamonds. Place the seven on the top of the deck, and then you can let the spectator cut the cards in half and then cut them in again, and this places our special card on top of the spectator's card. You can keep cutting the deck as many times as you want, it doesn't matter, and when you feel ready, all you're going to do is place the deck on the side like this, and then take your first finger and literally just flick upwards and it will catch the crimped card. So you flick up like that. You can see that the crimped card is the last one that was knocked over, so we know that the card underneath is the spectator's Seven of Diamonds.
I'm going to teach you how to make money from nothing.
Like that, you can literally just flick upwards and it will catch the crimped card. So you flick up like that. You can see that the crimped card is the last one that was knocked over, upwards, and it will catch as you want, it doesn't matter. And when you feel ready, all you're going to do is place the deck on the side like this, and then take your first finger and literally just flick upwards and it will catch the crimped card. So you flick up like that. You can see that the crimped card is the last one that was knocked over, so we know that the card underneath is the spectator's Seven of Diamonds.
I'm going to teach you how to make money from nothing. The magician has a piece of paper and two empty hands. He shows the paper and then folds it up. He tips the paper and a coin magically appears. This is a great little opener for a set of coin tricks.
Cut out two pieces of paper that are exactly the same size and then stick them to each other on all three sides, but leave the top side unstuck. Now simply place the coin inside the flap at the top and then makes a couple of folds like this, fold it into thirds and you're ready to begin. You can display the paper as one because it's stuck together. Fold the paper up and then hold your hand out and dump out the coin.
This is one of my favorite effects because it literally takes 5 seconds to learn, but is really visual and really powerful. The magician takes a deck of cards out of the box. He then rubs them under some cloth and nothing happens. He tries again, and this time the entire deck turns blue.
For this trick, you need a cloth, about 6 red cards, a blue deck, and a red box. Place the red cards on the bottom of the blue deck, but face down, so it looks like this, and then place this deck of cards inside the box. Open up the box, and as I open up the box, I don't just take them out like this, I deliberately skew some cards backwards, and it really sells the illusion that the entire deck of cards, and the box obviously, is red. Now take the cards, place them underneath the cloth, rub and reveal them, and obviously nothing has changed. Now what's going to happen is you're going to do the same thing, but when your hand is underneath the cloth, you're just going to flip the deck over. That's as simple as this trick is. So what you do is you take the cards, put them underneath the cloth, flip them, rub, and then when you show the cards again, all of them are blue.
One of the reasons I love magic so much is because it's always teaching you something new. And if you're looking to learn new skills or improve on existing ones, then check out this week's video sponsor, Skillshare. Skillshare is an online learning for you guys. And the first one
pull the first card towards you in a snapping motion. Keep practicing this move until it's almost instantaneous. Make sure the card is angled towards the spectator's eye line so they don't see the hidden card. Now add a third card. Pull the card that is closest to you away from the others, and then perform the snap change on the remaining two. The next trick is hypervisual. The magician shows both hands empty. He takes the lid off the bottle and then pushes the lid inside the bottle.
This trick requires a bottle that has a wrapper around it. Unpeel the wrapper, and then what you want to do is cut a hole in the wrapper, as you can see here, that's big enough for the cap to fit through. Once you've done that, reseal the wrapper, but not as tight as it was beforehand, leave it much looser. So you reseal it and move the wrapper, beforehand it was up here, move it slightly down as well. And what this means is a gap is created for the cap to go inside. Now from here, the rest of the trick is self-work and you can display the bottle as normal. No one will ever see the hole because it's covered by the wrapper and it looks completely normal. Then place the cap on your hand and tap once, twice, and then on the third tap, all you're doing is pushing the cap through the hole into the bottle, and then you can display that it's really in there.
The magician has two playing cards. The red card cleanly melts straight through the blue card. This is an effect that I created a while ago, and I recently saw another magician called Hondo performing a similar effect with a different method. So I'll teach you mine and leave a link in the description to his. Take two cards of the same color and cut one of them 3 centimeters from the top. Keep the big bits that you just cut off. Then take another card and cut 6 centimeters from the top. Keep the small bits that you just cut off. Turn over the big bits that you just kept, and then use some scissors to score down the back of the card 0.5 centimeter below where you cut it. Then fold the card as shown. The two parts of the card are going to be stuck together with some thin plastic. You can cut this off a bottle, or most people will have something lying around the house made from this plastic. Just cut off a strip of plastic about 5 centimeters long. Then place the cards like this and use some glue to stick the plastic onto the card. Now your gimmick will be able to create the illusion of a card passing through it. This usually works best on camera. This is the cleanest vanish you'll ever see. The magician places a coin in his hand and tosses it into his other hand, and the coin is gone.
This vanish completely fooled me when I first saw it. To begin, take some double-sided tape and put it on the back of the coin. You can then display this side of the coin very fairly and freely, and then place it onto your hand like so. What you then want to do is come over and literally act as if you're tossing the coin. The reason this is so convincing is there's no way that the coin should be able to stay on your hand, so you can just do that when in reality it stays here. Then, once your hand is this way round, use your thumb to simply push off the coin so it's on the table. So the coin goes from here to here, and now it's on the table. Vanish the coin, and at the same time as you vanish it, just turn your hand over, hiding the coin underneath it. You can do this